Are you tired of the complicated and time-consuming process of post-packing transactions? Welcome to our latest video where we have enhanced your experience by introducing a standalone transaction called Post-Packing OBLPN Updates and Handling Through Tasking. Let's dive onto the detail. With this new enhancement, the system allows you to perform various updates on the OBLPN based on your requirements. You can capture weight, perform printing, and more. Additionally, you can move the OBLPN between drop locations using task zone movements and finally put it away in loading or staging locations for shipping. A new task type, post-packing LPN handling, has been added and will be triggered through the following transactions: direct allocation, repack OBLPN, and combine OBLPN transaction. This allows you to create the new task type through Ctrl+T command. Let's take a look at the configuration details now. We are introducing a new task type called post-packing LPN handling in the task type UI. This task type allows you to perform post-packing updates and handling the transaction as part of a task along with task zone movements and OBLPN put away, apart from being a standalone transaction too. You may set the configuration for your flow by copying the task type record with asterisk and giving your own separate description. Now, navigate to the task type detail screen and where you can view the assigned task type, sequence number, module, and RF screen. Note, the first sequence number is always the packing program, such as the direct allocation or repack transaction through which the task is triggered using Ctrl+T command. Let's take an example and configure the programs or tasks for the selected module. Select RF program for sequence 2, 3, 4, and 5 as required. For example, you can configure RF program for sequence 2 and can skip sequence 4. This way the system will directly put away OBLPN. Note, depending on the operational flow, you can configure the RF program as required. And this is not a mandatory configuration. Let's set the direct allocation screen configuration. In the screen configuration UI, create a new RF screen for direct allocation. Click Create. Add module and screen name. Click Save. In the detail screen, set the value for parameters. Once done, add the newly added screen in your group menu. Let's create a task zone. In the task zone screen, click Create. Provide the necessary code and description. Click Save. The newly created task zone will appear on your screen. Now, let's set up task zone movement rule. In the task zone movement rule screen, set the task type, start zone, and end zone by providing corresponding values. Click Save. The newly create task zone movement rule will appear on your screen. Now, if you wish to set more drops in between, go to the detail screen and configure them. Provide values for equipment type, next drop, and sequence number. Click Save and the detail will appear on your screen. Follow the same process to add more drops. Now, let's walk you through the RF execution process. Navigate to the direct allocation RF screen to pack the outbound container. Scan the order number. Next, scan the inbound container that you want to allocate to the order. Press Enter. The OBLPN will be created and packed. You can continue packing more OBLPNs for the order as needed. Once you are done with packing, to perform the post-packing updates on these OBLPNs, press the hotkey Ctrl+T to trigger the task. Once the task is created, the system continues to the next program in the task. As configured, you can update the weight for the packed OBLPN here. Press Enter. The task continues into the next program, which is the task zone movement. Here, you are asked to scan a drop. Once done, the user 1 comes out of the task. Now, the second user continues the task by scanning the OBLPN from the drop. User 2 continues with the next program task zone movement and moves the LPN to the next drop. This continues till the OBLPN reaches the final drop slash task zone. Now when another user scans the OBLPN or task number, and you can continue the fourth program in the task, which is the post-packing transaction, configured to generate the OBLPN shipping information with the new updates made as part of this task. If needed, the new LPN type can also be captured here, after the new updates. OBLPN shipping file is now generated in the output interfaces UI. Now task continues into the final program of the task, OBLPN put away. In this final step, we are putting away the OBLPN to staging or loading station. As configured, scan the staging location. Press Enter. OBLPN is now staged and the execution is complete. Once the execution is complete, the status and data will be reflected in the task screen. That concludes our video for the new feature post-packing OBLPN updates and handling through tasking. We hope this enhancement will greatly improve your experience and streamline your post-packing processes. Thank you for watching.